empty out the can.
Hi everybody, so welcome back to the 90s. Anybody remember those old Pamela Anderson infomercials where she was showing off her makeup artist and basically what helped create that sort of Baywatch meets drag queen look? And it's super fun and just really, it's a real reinvention. So basically that overdrawn nudie lip a la Pam Anderson, you know, it kind of started with these celebrities that wanted this real bombshell look. And then when it trickled down into society, it became very grunge and it was not so bombshell. It was overlined lips, oh yes, with very dark lip liner, very nude lipstick, and most of the time not even gloss. So that's not the tutorial we'll be doing today. We're gonna be doing Pam. All right, I hope you stay tuned for the tutorial, enjoy it, and thank you for watching. To get started on your lips, you want to start with a very good exfoliator. And I'm going to be starting off with the LUSH Popcorn Scrub. Of course, you can pick any color you like. This just happens to be last year's limited edition, so I'll probably be throwing this away in December and getting my new limited edition jar. That's kind of my thing. It's my annual sugar scrub splurge. Of course, you can make a sugar scrub yourself if you're reinventing this a la drugstore. So once all the dead skin cells are off, you want to be sure to condition. I usually like to do this before I start any of the tutorial, any of the eye makeup, any of that. This is part of my initial prep. It kind of comes right after I've done all my like mini facial-y skincare stuff, just so that everything looks super smooth and your makeup is amplifying your beauty and not wearing you. So I'm going to put a little bit of foundation over the top of my lips. Today I'm wearing a custom blend of my Becca and Josie Moran Argan Tinted Moisturizer. When it comes to Pam, you want that overlined nude lip. This was extremely on trend in the 90s, the overlined lip, but you can still do it today. It's a lot of fun. Since the 90s are definitely back in full swing, you definitely want to learn how to do a good overlined lip. Now, I lived in the Orange County, LA areas when the overlined lip trend was on. This is sort of my new MAC Spice, or whatever you want to call it. Lot 192 lipstick. Feel free to color in the lips. You know my thing. You have to line lips and color them in, but this is a 90s tutorial, so I won't be coloring them in. 224, which is a peachy nude with shimmer. I love this color. These are a couple of my favorite nudes, and they're from different color families as well, so there is a reason to own them both. I remember I was like, oh, I want to wear nude to my sister's wedding, but I don't want it to look too brown, too 90s. So I picked up a pink and a peachy nude. So these are both really good staples to have in your kit if you're a nude fan. So once you're done with that, go back in and line again. Now Pam Anderson wore anything from a shimmery nude to a matte nude, but her staple look was the overline glossy nude mouth with heavy outline lips. I'm going to be taking the Inglot Slicks Cream Gloss in 100. Try it out. If you don't like nude, not saying you have to do it this way. If you don't like nude, try it in hot pink. You know, go for it. Yeah. I know there are a lot of 90s lips on YouTube today, but I thought I'd strike a note with a different 90s actress who I believe really sort of invented this sort of overdrawn, almost like a nude drag queen mouth. So yeah, hope you enjoy. Thank you for watching.
Empty out the cash. Count what you have left.